Hello friends, today we'll be talking about Delhi Sultanate. This is chapter 3 and this will be the first in a series of 4 videos on this chapter. So, if you visit or stay in Delhi, you will come across several monuments built by various rulers. Delhi has been under the rule of several prominent rulers and dynasties throughout the history. Let's read about the Delhi Sultanate, a phase which saw the emergence of various rulers and along with them their culture and administrative structure. What we'll be reading about today is the rise of Delhi Sultanate and the slave dynasty. So, the period of Delhi Sultanate is an important period in the history of India. This period begins in the later medieval period from 1206 CE to 1526 CE. 5 dynasties ruled during this period, beginning with Slave Dynasty, Khalji Dynasty, Tughlaq Dynasty, Sayyid Dynasty and ending with the Lodi Dynasty. So, let's study about the rise of Delhi Sultanate. The importance of the city of Delhi became evident in the later medieval period. In the early medieval period, Delhi began to develop into an important place. Tomar Rajputs were the first to make Delhi their capital city. In the middle of the 12th century, they were defeated by Chauhans of Ajmer, also known as Chahamanas. Both Tomars and Chauhans contributed in the development of Delhi as a city of trade and commerce. Coins called Delhi Wal were also minted in Delhi during this period. Delhi gained more importance as a royal capital city by the beginning of the 13th century. The rule of Chauhans came to an end with the defeat of Prithviraj Chauhan by Muhammad Ghori in the Second Battle of Tarain. This opened the way for Turkish rulers to establish their dominance over Delhi. Muhammad Ghori died without an heir. Hence, his generals captured his territories and established their rule. Qutbuddin Aibak established his rule over the Indian territories and thus began the phase of Delhi Sultanate. This turned Delhi into a central place for control of over other territories. Sources of Delhi, sources of the Sultanate period. Now, the sultans of Delhi patronized historians, court chroniclers, writers, and scribes. The Turco-Arab tradition of recording events made court chronicles the most valuable sources of information. This led to an organized system of record keeping, and we can find many archaeological and literary sources. Inscriptions, coins and monuments provide a lot of information about this period. The travelogues of Zayaduddin Barani, Siraj Afif, Minhaj Siraj and Ibn Battuta and Marco Polo, who visited the subcontinent during this period, also provide valuable information about the reigns of Sultanate of Delhi. Persian historians' records are called Tariq, that is singular, or Tawarikh, that is plural, written by different people such as administrators, courtiers, poets, etc., are also important literary sources. Now, coming to the slave dynasty. The rulers of this dynasty were Mamluk sultans. Mamluk in Arabic means owned. The early sultans of this dynasty were actually slaves but later came to the powerful positions. So Qutbuddin Aibak, who reigned from 1206 to 1210 CE. Qutbuddin Aibak was the founder of the slave dynasty, also called Mamluk dynasty. He ruled for just 4 years. He was Muhammad Ghori's slave and a capable general. Qutbuddin established his control over Delhi after Muhammad Ghori's death. This new kingdom is described in history as the first dynasty of the Delhi Sultanate. He was a kind-hearted and charitable ruler. He initiated the construction of Qutub Minar in Delhi and made Delhi his royal capital. Shamsuddin Iltutmish, from 1210 to 1236 CE. Qutbuddin Aibak was succeeded by his son-in-law Iltutmish. Iltutmish had to face numerous revolts, including revolt from Qutbuddin Aibak's son. But he crushed these revolts and strengthened the empire. He sent expeditions against the rebelling Rajput at Gwalior, Ranthambore, Ujjain, Bayana and Ajmer. Rajput rulers of Ujjain and Ranthambore were defeated. He also gained control over Gwalior, Ajmer and Bayana. Iltutmish suppressed the revolts at Bihar and Bengal and annexed them. He occupied Lahore after defeating Kobacha. He also protected the northwest frontier of the Delhi Sultanate against possible invasion from Genghis Khan and the Mongols. He completed the construction of Qutub Minar, which was started by his predecessor. In order to have an effective and efficient administrative system, he organized a group of 40 nobles called Chahalgani. Iltutmish had many sons, but he did not find any of them worthy. He made his daughter Sultana the Sultan of Delhi. This decision was not liked by conservative nobles who had become very powerful. After the death of Iltutmish, they placed Rukn-uddin Firoz Shah, one of the many sons of Iltutmish, on the throne. Rukn-uddin Firoz Shah did not have the qualities of a king. He completely neglected the empire, so the nobles reluctantly made Razia the ruler of Delhi. Razia Sultana from 1236 to 1240 CE. Razia was the only Muslim ruler of Delhi. She succeeded her brother Rukn-uddin Firoz Shah. She was well liked by common people. Minhaj al-Siraj, a court chronicler, believed that Razia had all the qualities of a good ruler and was more worthy than the title than any of her brothers. But since she was a female, she could not be accepted. Razia's reign was short-lived and full of problems. The nobles, especially Chahalgani, could not tolerate a woman's rule. They wanted power in their hands. Therefore, they conspired against her. Her grave is near Turkman Gate in Delhi. Period from 1240 to 1266. Now, Razia's death did not solve anything, but it certainly created a powerful vacuum. Period from 1240 to 1266 saw many political disturbances. Nasiruddin Mahmud, another son of Iltutmish, ruled from 1246 to 1266 CE. He was not a capable ruler and ruled like a puppet with the support of nobles. During Nasiruddin's reign, Balban, who was a powerful noble, controlled the entire administration. In 1266, after the death of Nasiruddin, Balban himself came to the power. He proved to be the most powerful ruler of the slave dynasty. Ghiyazuddin Balban from 1266 to 1287 CE. Balban was a very powerful noble. After becoming the Sultan, Balban reorganized and strengthened the army. He led many campaigns against the local rulers and defeated them. To settle the colonies for Afghan soldiers, he cleared the jungles around Delhi. By settling these colonies, he also checked the Mewatis who hid in jungles and created problems. Balban also successfully guarded the northwestern front borders of his empire against the Mongol raids. As a Sultan, Balban adopted a blood and iron policy. He knew that during the 20-year rule of the Nasiruddin, the Chahalgan had become very strong. Moreover, they did not like the growing power of Balban and were jealous of his ascent. So after becoming Sultan, Balban decided to crush the power of Chahalgani. He put a few Chahalgani to death and while others were banished to far-off places. Balban introduced the Persian custom of Sijad, Peabos or Zaminbos. According to the common people, such customs were reserved for one and only supreme god. Therefore, they considered it un-Islamic. The successors of Balban were weak and could not hold the power. This allowed the Khalji tribe to kill the last ruler of Saib dynasty and establish their rule. Emergence of strong empire. In the early phase of Delhi Sultanate, the sultans were satisfied with their control over fortified towns and didn't make any efforts to move out of the safety or to control the hinterlands. Thus, the supplies for cities were heavily dependent upon trade, tribute and plunder. This, however, had led to various other problems such as difficulty in controlling the captured territories that were far away from the fortified town of the Sultan. The Mongols were also a constant threat to Sultan's authority over Delhi. The nobles and the generals looked for any opportunity to establish their authority and overthrow the Sultan. The later strong rulers of the slave dynasty like Ghiyazuddin Balban, however, effectively dealt with all the problems and were able to establish a strong empire. So, friends, in the next lecture, we will be continuing with the Khalji dynasty. So, To summarize what we have just covered in this, we had talked about rise of Delhi Sultanate, we have talked about slave dynasty, its rulers, that is Qutbuddin Aibak, Shamsuddin Iltutmish, Razia Sultana, Ghiyasuddin Balban, and how this strong empire emerged. I hope, friends, this would have helped you with this part of the chapter, and rest we will be covering in the next lectures. Thank you.